What's up everyone? In this video, I'm going to show how you can unprotect a protected Excel workbook without VBA, even if you forgot the password for it. For disclaimers, you should not be doing this for any malicious purposes, and this method should work for any Excel files with the extension type of XLSX or XLSM. So if you're using something like XLS, then it might not work. So with that said, let's get this started. When we protect the structure of an Excel workbook, it means that we don't want anyone to add, delete, hide, or rename any of the worksheets. If we want to protect the structure, then what we do is that we go to the Review tab, go to Protect Workbook button here, click on it, and we're going to be prompted to enter a password. I'm going to type out lowercase a, and we want to leave this as checkmark, the structure. Click OK. We're going to be prompted to enter it again, lowercase a. Click OK. Now we've protected the structure of the workbook. So if I try to add a new worksheet by clicking on the plus sign, I can't really do that. If I do a right click on the worksheet name, I don't have the option to hide or unhide anything, and I can't rename or delete or do anything else either. If I want to unprotect the workbook but forgot the password, then we can use the zip method, which I'm going to show you right now. I'm going to go to the folder path containing the Excel file, which is this one, and the first thing I'm going to do is that I'm going to make a copy of the workbook. So I'm going to right click this, and then you can do a copy or you can do Control C, and then I'm just going to paste another version here. We'll just name this copy as our backup file. You always want to make a backup file in case the workbook you're working on gets corrupted by this method. Next, I'm going to go to the View tab, and then I'm going to go to Show, and I want to checkmark file name extensions so that I can show the file extension for each file appearing in that folder. From the file I've selected, I want to rename the file so that I can change the extension from an XLSX file to a zip file. I can do an F2, and then I can just change this from .xlsx to .zip, press enter, and we're going to get this message. I'm just going to click on yes, and now we have the zip file here. The next thing I want to do is that I want to find a specific XML file inside the zip folder. I'm going to double click, then go to Excel folder, and then go to the workbook.xml file here, and double click it. What I want to do is that I want to open this up in a notepad. So I'll select Notepad, and once I open it up, I get this text file here containing all the XML language related to the Excel file. We want to look for a specific keyword called Workbook Protections where the letter P is capitalized. I can do a Control F, and I'm going to type out WORKBOOK, and then capital P, and then just fill out Protection, press Enter. And we got this search result returned. I'll just close this out, and there's two ways you can do this. I can highlight everything from the lesson sign, workbook protection, all the way to the log structure equal to 1, and then close by greater than sign. And then I can just delete this entire sentence, and then save the text file in the same folder, save, close this out. And if I go back to the folder, we have the workbook.xml edited version here. So what I want to do is that I want to delete the original workbook.xml file. Delete this, and then just cut and paste the edited version into that same location, and paste it here. Next, we want to convert the zip file back to an XLSX file. I'm going to go back to the folder path containing the Excel file, and I'm going to rename this zip file, press the F2 button, from .zip to .xlsx, press enter. We get the same message as before, click on yes. And now we have the original Excel file back. I'm going to open up the copied version of the Excel file to see if the workbook protection is still enabled. Double click this. And we have the file opened up now. So if I go back to the Review tab, we can see that the Protect Workbook button isn't enabled so far. And if we want to confirm, I can click on the plus sign to see if I can add a new worksheet, which I can do. I can right click this, and I have all these options enabled again as well. I mentioned before that there's another way you can unprotect the workbook from that XML text file we were working on before. So let's go back to the original text file before we made any changes to it. Before, we deleted the tagline to unprotect the workbook, but instead of deleting whatever I highlighted here, we can instead change the log structure from 1 to 0. In Boolean, 1 represents true and 0 represents false. So if we change it to 0, that's saying log structure equals to false. I'm going to save this text file again in the same spot as before. Close this. And I'm just going to delete the original XML file. And then just cut this and paste it into the same folder spot where we deleted the original file. Go back. and then change this from a .zip file to a .xlsx file. If we open this up again, we have the copied version opened up now. So I'm going to see if I can add worksheet, which I can do here. And it looks like all these features are unprotected, same as before. So that's another way of unprotecting your workbook. Instead of deleting the line, you can change the lock structure from 1 to 0. I hope this video was helpful in showcasing an easy and efficient way to unprotect the workbook structure of an XLSX or XLSM file if you ever forget your password. With this method, you don't need to use VBA or any third-party tools. Please like and comment down below what else you'd want to see. And if you haven't already, subscribe. You can also follow me on Instagram and LinkedIn to get the latest update on when I upload a new video. Until then, I'll see you guys again next time.